And then let's get to last night's game, coaches. I'm sure the conversation of your accomplishments got lost quite a bit in the aftermath of the game because of the insertion of Nate Sudfeld into the game when it was winnable for both teams. What did you think when Sudfeld trotted on the field last night?
I didn't think anything of it. I really didn't. You know, it's interesting, when one team's playing for something and somebody else isn't, the other team can do whatever they want in terms of players they play, plays they run. I think, you know, people get upset about it for whatever the reason is. But people got to understand that a coach is going to do what he thinks is best for his team's growth and development going forward. And so I don't begrudge it because – you know, you get in these situations, people go, well, you know, look what happened. Yeah, well, look what happened to us 2 weeks ago. Nobody cared that Alex couldn't play. Nobody cared that Terry McLaurin wasn't going to play. You know, nobody said, oh, let's make it even. You know, don't let your starters play. That's what happens. And so if a coach decides something, you know, that's what he decides. I mean, I've been in that situation in the past where I said, hey, let's play them all. Get them all out there. Give them opportunities. You know, but it's just – you know, I get it. People want to make something of it. That's fine. If they need something to talk about, that's fine. You know, I've had people say, you know, you should have never gotten the playoffs at 7-8-1, but yet we win a playoff game and we have a chance to win a second one, in the 2014 season. You know, and people say, oh, you shouldn't have got in, but at the time we were hot. We won four in a row to get there. So, you know, for us to tell people what they should do with their teams and how they should do it. That's hey, he does what he thinks is best for his team going forward.
Hey, you watched all the way to the end. Thanks for that. Watch more right here.